Morning. Where is everybody? Oh, they're all at the retreat. I know that's where Mickey and Amy and a few others are. So, okay, so we're here all by ourselves today. So you're just going to have to sing real loud, okay? So we're going to start out with stand up for Jesus. So let's everybody stand. To be Mickey. Good morning. Good morning, Mickey. Okay. No, Mickey. No, good morning, Mickey. Okay. Well, and Bill, the other half of Mickey, can't get the bulletins to work, but we can get one page at a time, and it's very small print. So I'm not even going to attempt to read all of the prayer requests and all this other stuff. There is one new one, Cindy Gazelle, health problems, and it's Bill's sister. So if you got last week's program, you find it and look at all of those. Mickey and Amy and all the ladies, our guests, are at a retreat, and when they're not here, their husbands don't move. They just stay home and loaf around. So we got pictures from Daryl and Melanie and Romina and Fabian, and I guess they look like they're having a good time in Washington, D.C., and I guess this weekend they're in Louisville for the annual chaplains pastors meeting, but they will be back on Tuesday the 4th, so there will be Bible classes on Wednesday and Thursday at 5 p.m., and the kids will meet on Thursday night and also Sunday morning at 5 and also Sunday morning at 10:30, so. Those are pretty much all of the announcements we have today. So you get off real easy. So will you join me in prayer for the services this morning? Dear Heavenly Father, we do thank you so much for all the people that are here and gathered here, and for Evan who's coming today again to bring a message to us and deliver your word for us in a sermon today. And we ask to be with all the people that are on the prayer requests, and you know what the needs are for them, and we know you can help and comfort the families that need it. And work with the doctors for the people who have health problems. And you can do all these things that we can't do, and you know what they all are. And we just ask you to be with us as we go through the service for the rest of this morning and watch over us and guide us in what we do. And continue to be with us as we go through the next week. And we ask all these things to be with Melanie and Daryl and Fabian and Rowena as they travel back to us, and be sure that they're safe. And we thank you for all you do for us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let's sing Blessed Assurance. I can move the other chair now. Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchased of God. Born of his spirit, washed in his blood. This is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, perfect delight, visions of rapture now burst on my sight. Angels descending, bring from above echoes of mercy. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Submission, all is at rest, I am my Savior. Happy and blessed, watching and waiting, looking above, filled with his goodness, lost in his love. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story. Savior all the day long. Then we're going to do Rock of Ages. Rock of Ages, cleft for me, let me hide myself in thee. Let the water and the blood from your wounded side which flow be of sin the double cure. Cleanse me from its guilt and power, not the labors of my hands can fulfill your law's demands. Could my zeal myself in thee. Now, Michael, I'd just like to do a little bit of one more for you before Evan comes to bring the message to us, that just as I am. Without one plea, you, Michael. Evan, come preach to us, fella. Good to have you back again. I'll sit by you.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I see they have raised the altar, the pulpit for sharp people like me. Well, I thank God for being here with you again.
Are you turned on? I know I am.
Check, 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 check.
I'm not anymore, though.
Check, check, check.
Yes,
check.
I am.
Check, check, check. Well, that's what they say. Technology is good when it's working. Check, 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 check. Check. Seems like every time I come here, I have a problem with the microphones. Well, thank you guys. For inviting us here back again. I didn't expect to be here. But God has made another opportunity so that we can be here again today with you guys. And I'm really glad to be back again. And so last Sunday, I spoke about why, what do you do when in crisis? So I when Daryl asked me to be here again today, I asked myself, God, what do you want me to speak? And I thought of a topic this morning, why we ought to thank God always. And this, the sermon that I'm about to preach today is a sermon that I think I preached 2 years ago. And 2 years ago during Thanksgiving. But the Lord reminded me, we don't only thank God in Thanksgiving. Our thanks to Him should be always. And so today I just want to speak in with you in a simple scripture that you all know and probably you've heard about. There we go. Okay. So before I go into the Word of God, I'd just like us to bow down. You're sitting right next to somebody. I always like doing things together. The Bible says where two or three are gathered in His name, there His presence is. And I believe we are all in one in Christ. And so as we gather together, as we pray together, there is power when we all pray together. Father, we thank you this morning. Thank you for giving us this opportunity to be here again today in your presence, God. How we open our hearts that you may speak to us this morning. Transform our hearts. Renew our minds this morning, God. Where can we go? What can we do without you, God? And so we come to you this morning. That you speak a word that will bring life, that will challenge us, Lord God, to walk into the ways that you want us to, God. Thank you for everyone that is here. Lord, you know their need. I pray that you're going to meet them according to their points of need this morning. Speak a word to me. Change me, God, as you change other people up to your word this morning. May your word that comes from above not go back to you in vain, but may it accomplish in its purpose this morning. I pray this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Well, your pastor Larry probably doesn't wear a t-shirt when he comes here. Right. So that you don't have question mark, well, why is he wearing a t-shirt today? I'm not always wearing a t-shirt, but today we have a meeting, we have a mission. Team that is going to Kenya with us this summer, and so these are some of the t-shirts that we printed out for everyone that will be going, and they will be selling them on their own to raise money for the mission trip. So I thought, well, today since we're doing the meeting, I should wear one as I go to the meeting and show everybody what we got today. Okay, so that's where I'm wearing it today. So with that cleared out of the way, let's go back to the Word of God. We are going to read in the book of 1 Thessalonians, chapter number 5, verses 16 through 18, but I will dwell majorly in verses 18. In verses 18, thank you for putting that up there. And so if you have your Bible, holidays in Kenya we don't, because I think maybe we celebrate Thanksgiving every day. But in the United States, we have a functioning Thanksgiving, where we have a Thanksgiving family comes together. And that is where I preached this sermon 2 years ago, in Thanksgiving. But I thought Thanksgiving to God should be always. And as you read in the scripture, the Bible says, in 1 Thessalonians chapter number 5, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. And rejoice always, pray continuously, give thanks in all circumstances. So today I thought, we are not only in circumstances, or we don't only give Thanksgiving on Thanksgiving Day. And so God spoke to me, because a few things have happened to my life personally. Before I always preach to people, I preach to myself. So if someone doesn't preach to me, then it's not worthy to preach it to you. Amen. And so this morning I thought, I asked God, God, what do you want me to preach? Or what do you want me to teach you people when I go down at the restaurant? And so this is what God brought to me. And today I just want to look into why we ought to give thanks always to God. Because He deserves it. Amen. The most taken for granted person in the universe is God. And we as Christians especially, we among everyone else, we as Christians, we should always give thanks to God. Always. And the Bible says give thanks to God in all circumstances. In all circumstances. Not when all means everything. Not when things are only going good or not only in Thanksgiving, but we are always required to do that. And the reason why I realize most people, we take God for granted. We don't see God in anything in our lives. We don't see God when we wake up in the morning. We don't see God when we have that job. We don't see God when that check comes in. We don't see God when our family is doing well. We don't even think that there is a God that is behind everything that is happening. And so I want us to turn in the book of Psalm 103, and I'll read from verse 1 through 5. Psalms, the book of Psalms 103. Today I'll try not to be a preacher, but I'll try to be a teacher. If you have your Bible, open Psalm 103 and I'll read it so that we may leave here early. I know I've been taking much time when I'm here, but I'll try. Praise the Lord, O my soul, all my inmost being. Praise His holy name. Praise the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all His benefit, who forgives all your sins and heals all your diseases, who redeems your life from the pit and crowns you with love and compassion, who satisfies your desire with good things, so that your youth is renewed like the eagle. The Bible says, forget not the benefits of God. Rejoice, praise Him. Praise the Lord, my soul. Do not forget He who has forgiven you. And as we are gearing towards Easter, it is my prayer that we will see the reason why we are celebrating Easter. We will be thankful for what Jesus did some years back on the cross for us, that we may be forgiven of all our sins. We may see that we were not only able to take ourselves out of sin, but someone had to die for our sins. And that's why I thought it is good that I remind you today that we should always be thankful. Don't forget the benefit of God, because God is good. There is absolutely nothing that you do that does not depend upon God. Your everyday walk, when you wake up in the morning, for you to live is God. The Bible says in the book of Acts, chapter number 17, verse 28, for in Him we live, in Him we move, in Him we have our everything. There is nothing that we do that does not depend upon God. Even the non-Christians that don't believe in God, they don't know. But you and me should always know that for me to live, for me to have the bread that I have today, it depends upon God. There's nothing that happened in your life by chance without God knowing. In Psalms 139, the Bible says, where can I go from your spirit? For if I go in the heavens, there you are. If I go in the darkest place, there you are. There's nothing about me that you don't know. There's nothing that happens in our life that God does not know. He's always in the know. He's a knowing all God. He knows even the number of hairs on your head. So he's a good God. We always need to give thanks to him because there's nothing that we can do that does not depend upon God. As someone once told me some years back, that God is like water that we drink. Even if you refuse to take bath with him, you'll still drink him. You'll see him in everything. And that's why scientists have tried to prove that there is no God, but they can't, because God is in everything. They have tried to take God out of everything, but God still exists in everything. Amen. And Psalm 93 says, praise God because he's good. Give thanks to him because he's a good God. Is God being good to you? Has he been good to you? And if you think that God has not been good to you, as you hear towards Easter, think of how you were before Christ came into your life. Amen. And when you look this, when you look at First Thessalonians chapter number 5, this is Paul commanding us. It is a command to the believers. It is a command to the believers. Be joyful always, pray continually, give thanks in all circumstances. When I look at this, I realize that it is not that Paul is saying, but he's saying give thanks in all things. He's not saying give thanks for all things. Because let me give an example. For example, your house burned today, and you give thanks. You don't want to give thanks. It's really, I can't give thanks because my house is bad. But he's saying, give thanks in all things, not for all things. Well, my house is bad. I'll give thanks in that situation. I'll give thanks in the midst of that second. I'll give thanks in the midst of everything not working right in my life. I'll give thanks when things are going right. And I realize one thing, the reason why we are not grateful is because we are not grateful even when good things happen to us. So we don't know how to be grateful in the midst of the bad things that are happening in our lives. Because when we are grateful, when good things are happening in our lives, we will realize that God was good then. He can still be good even in the midst of the storm that we are passing through. But if we don't see God in the goodness, in his goodness, then it's all the same. We don't know how to thank him. We don't know how to say, thank you, God, in this situation, because I know that I'm not alone. The reason why I'm saying we thank God in the midst of the circumstance is because in the midst of the circumstance, you are not alone. God is with you. The Bible says when you go through fire, when you pass through the midst of fire, I will be with you. You are not alone. He's not only with you, but he takes you out of the situation. Amen?
Amen.
When you look into the book of Luke, chapter number 17, we are told in this scripture that there's 10 lepers that came to Jesus and they asked Jesus, heal us. And Jesus told them, go show yourself to the priest. On their way to the priest, all their skin was healed. And only one turned back and went and praised God. And Jesus is asking, where are the 9? Did I send out 10? Why is there only one that came back? Ask yourself today, are you among the 9 or are you among the 1 that came back and said, thank you, God? Now, when I look at this, I was asking myself, where were the 9? The 9 were consumed with a blessing more than the blesser. And are we all always fall into this category? Most of the time, when God blesses, especially in the United States, this is what I've realized. Back in Africa, this is what we know. That the United States was a nation that was founded under God. everybody, most of the people that will try probably to know the history or to understand the United States, they will tell you one thing we know about the United States. It was a nation that was founded under God. But now we are trying to take God out of everything. God has blessed us too much that we don't see him in the we don't see him anymore in the blessing, but we see the blessing as our own, that we deserve it. We are among the nine that we are consumed with the blessing more than he who has given us the blessing. It is my prayer that as you live here, you will not be consumed with the blessing that God has given you, but you'll be consumed with him who has given you the blessing. And you'll be grateful to him for you to have the blessing. I know you're asking yourself, I don't see any blessing in my life. I don't see any good thing in my life right now. What good can I thank God for when all my family is going astray, when my health is not right, when this and this is happening in my life? The Bible tells us to give thanks in all things. And I'll tell you why. Number one, it is a command, because Paul requires, he's commanding us to give thanks in all circumstances. Because in all these circumstances, when we give thanks, God is with us. We are not alone. We are not fighting the battle by yourself. Remember last Sunday when I mentioned here, when Jehoshaphat gave thanks to God, he went ahead and he led the battle. The Bible says that the battle did not belong to him anymore, but it belonged to God. It didn't mean that the battle was not there. It was there. But the thing about it is God was in the battle. It was God now fighting the battle. And so when we are in the midst of the storm and we thank God, God is in the battle with us to take us out of the battle. We are not fighting alone. We are not fighting the health issues alone. We are not fighting the financial issues alone. We are not fighting the relational issues alone. But we are with God. And we as Christians, we ought to thank God because we are not alone in this circumstance. The problem is today, with our today's society, or when you hear other preachers, I'm not here to bash any preacher, but what you hear about the prosperity gospel is that God always gives good things. God doesn't allow other things to happen. And so people are made to believe that if God cannot bless me, then he's not God. And it reminds me, I look back in the life of Job, and I say, well, what happened in the life of Job then? And the thing about it, we don't love God or we don't give thanks to God because of the material possession that he's given us, but we love him because of who he is to us, because of how much he loves us. But the gospel that is being preached today is about God blessing us, God giving us material stuff. It's not only about material stuff, but it is about the love that he has for us and the love that we have. Because that is why you see many people when they are sick or when nothing goes well with them, then they think God is not there. God does not exist. I don't say that God does not give us good things. He gives us good things. He blesses us with good things. But we should also remember that we are living in this world and bad things will happen. But the good thing about these bad things happening is that God is in the midst of these things with us. Amen. So we always ought to thank God because he's with us. And I look at Job's life, his wife is saying, do what real men do. You know, God has left you, he has abandoned you. Why don't you cast God and die? This is the best time for you to cast God. And so all of us probably have been in a situation whereby you think God is not there. And so his wife comes to him, you don't have nothing. And I don't think any of us have been through that situation that Job was in. His employees are all gone. Flocks are all gone. Wealth is gone. His children are gone. His health is gone. He is down to nothing. And I think when you're down to nothing, it's easier to say to hell with God. And so his wife fell into that temptation. will men do? This is the best time. Cast God and die. Instead of finding or casting God in the problem, find a reason to thank God in the circumstances. You as a believer, instead of casting God or turning away from God, find a reason. Just find that one reason that you can thank God. That will give you strength, will build your faith to overcome the situation. Amen. It reminds me again of Jesus with the two loaves. Remember earlier I said something, the reason why we are not grateful for what we have is because sometimes we don't see God in the good that He's given us, so it's hard for us to thank God in the bad things. Jesus is teaching us a perfect example when He had the two fish and the five loaves of bread. It's a perfect example here. The first thing Jesus did, he asked for the things to be brought to Him. And the first thing He do, He thanked God for what He had. And God multiplied. What is Jesus trying to teach? He's not only teaching us about multiplication, but Jesus is teaching us one thing here. Thank God for what you have and don't complain for what you don't have or what you need. But we are always complaining of what we need, of what we want. The first thing that you're supposed to be doing is thank God. God, I thank you because I have life today. Even though I don't have money, I know God, you're able to provide tomorrow. I thank you that you've given me the good health today. I work in the hospital, and maybe some of you have seen me there. And when you see some people are really struggling, and I always look at that, and I'm like, God, I thank you that I have this life. I might not have all the money or all the other stuff, but thank you, God, that I have this life. Because some people are just struggling for that life, for that life that they can even just say, hey, but they can't. But you, God, has given you life, and you're complaining about the things that you don't have. So number one, Jesus is teaching us here is that thank God for what you have, not complaining about the things that you don't have. I'm about to get done. Just bear with me. And in Kenya, I don't know if I told you this last time, when somebody tells me, I'll be done in 30 minutes, you give him another 2 hours. But I'll try to be an American. Okay. We give thanks to God always because it is His will. The Bible says, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ. I said this last time. When you complain, you're not in the will of God. It is the will of God that you thank God in all circumstances. But when you complain, we all have been there. We all have complained. So just remember this. If there's one thing that you need to remember today, is that when you complain, when you're complaining, when you're finding reasons to complain, remember that you are outside God's will. Because it is His will that you thank Him. Amen? But most of us are there. We complain. We even have professional complainers that complain without pay voluntarily. They don't pay you. It's an occupation that they don't pay you to complain, but you complain. But it is my prayer that you thank God, that you will be in the will of God. When you thank God, you are in His will. For the Bible clearly says, for this is God's will for you in Christ. To thank Him in all circumstances. Thank God in all circumstances. Why is it God's will, and why is it important that I thank God? I'm about to land the plane. Why is it important to thank God? Because it is His will. Romans 8:28 gives us a perfect example. For we know that in all these things is working together for good. Why do I need to thank God? Because I know in the midst of this storm is working together for good. And this reminded me, as we're getting towards this season, this reminded me of Jesus. The enemy thought, or Satan thought, that he was clever enough when he used people to kill Jesus. without knowing that he was not wise enough to know that all of these things were lacking for the glory of God. Amen. So when you look at the Bible, there are a lot of stories that you can read about Joseph. It reminds me of Joseph. And Joseph was sold with his brother rather than complaining and all that. Joseph still find a reason to seek God and find God. And Joseph, in the book of Genesis, Joseph said, whatever they made for evil, God has used it for good. God has used it for good. In other words, we thank God because He is working together for good. You might not know the ingredients that are cooking together. When you look into your life, where did that come from? When you look into your life, and you see how things are happening, you're like, I don't see any good thing working, anything working good. I don't see it. But God uses every situation. The Bible says, in all things, we know that it's working together for good. So I have a reason to thank Him. I have a reason to thank God because He's working together for my good. He's working together for your good. Regardless of the situation, know that He's working together for your good. When Jesus died on the cross, probably the devil or people were celebrating, the Jewish were celebrating that we are done with that era. It's all gone. But God has used that circumstance. God used that situation to work it for good. And today, we can come to the throne of grace and be forgiven of our sins. Because one man died for us. As you live here today, I want you to ask yourself, am I among the nine, or am I among the one leper that came back and said, thank you, God? Am I one person that complains about everything, complains of what I don't have, rather than thanking God for what I have? Do I do that? Do I know that God is working together for good in the midst of the storm? I want you to remember that God is in control and God is working together for good to them that love Him. He's bringing all the ingredients together. You might see a lot of things not working your way, but I know for sure tonight, today, tomorrow, that I ought to thank Him, because I know as a Christian, I am not alone. And there's nothing that I do that does not depend upon Him. He knows you. He knows every single move that you make. He knows when you lay down. The Bible says in Psalms 139, when I lay down, you know me. When I rise up, you know me. You know my every move. You know everywhere I go. So for this reason, you as a Christian, you deserve to thank God. It is His will that you thank Him in Christ Jesus. It is His will that we thank God. Are you among the nine? Are you among the people that are complaining? I want you to look into your life. What is it that you can thank God? Just find one thing that you can thank God for today. I know things might not be looking right. You might be saying, well, you don't know what's happening in my life. He is working together for good. Well, you don't know what is happening in my family today. When you don't know what is happening with my life, I'm battling cancer. I'm battling this. I'm having these issues happening in my life. He is working together for good. He says, in all things, the negative, the bad things. And Joseph said it clearly. Whatever the enemy, whatever you guys meant for evil, God has used it for good. Can I remind you of one story before I finish? Moses. Who knew Moses would one day become the deliverer of the children of Israel? His mother gets wisdom, they throw him in the river. They bring Moses back to his own mother. They pay Moses' own mother to raise his own child. It all happened. It worked together for good. And this is in the midst when they were killing
all the young men, and Moses survived. Moses was raised as a king's daughter, as a king's son. In all things, regardless of the situation that we are in through, know that God is working together for good. May we stand up on our feet. Can you find a reason this morning to thank God? You know, if you cannot find any reason this morning, just ask yourself, this morning I woke up, I didn't wake up in the... I know it's hard to say this, but I'll say it. You didn't wake up in the hospital. You didn't wake up, or you didn't... You wake up. You didn't sleep forever. Some people slept forever. They never woke up. If you don't have any reason to thank God this morning, if you're complaining about what is this and this and this and this, we, especially now, it's easier to complain about the government this, the government that, the, this and this and this and this. We are fond to complaining. But I want you as a Christian to not take God for granted. Like I say in the beginning, he's the only person in this world. The only person in this world that is taken for granted is God. He's done a lot of good things to you. And remembering all these good things and thanking God in these good things will help you to also overcome the circumstances that you're in. Father, we thank you this morning. Thank you for speaking with us and thank you for reminding us to be always grateful and thankful and not complaining, God. For it is your will that we thank you always. For in all things, God, you're working together for good. I don't know who you send me here to speak to, or you send me to speak to myself, or whoever you send me to speak to, God, the people that are here this morning. I believe it is a reminder of us taking God for taking you for granted, God. Not knowing that in all things that we do, God, you are in everything. I thank you again. I thank you for waking me up this morning in my right mind. I thank you for allowing me to be in the assembly of the believers. And Father, if there's anyone here that is not finding a reason to thank you, Father, may you lead them to the cross to find you and find a reason to be thankful. I pray that in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you, Evan. Thank you. Good job. I think we've been asking for God's blessing on this country, but I think a lot of times we forget to thank him for everything that we have here. I don't know if we've traveled anywhere in the world and all over the world, you can really be glad every time you come back to this country. It's still the greatest country in the world. And I think we need to continue to give him thanks for that, and we still continue to ask God's blessings. And let's sing God Bless America.
God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the night.
Pray for Daryl and Melanie and all those that are coming back home to keep safe.